Hello students, in this video you are going to learn all about blood pressure. Let's start. First we will see what is blood pressure. The simple definition for blood pressure is that it is the force or pressure exerted by the circulating blood on the vessel walls, specifically on the walls of arteries. Blood pressure usually refers to the pressure in large arteries of the systemic circulation, because the heart pumps the oxygenated blood into the aorta, from where the blood directly flows into the arteries, and pressure is felt on the arterial wall. Therefore, it is also called the arterial blood pressure. The unit of measuring blood pressure is millimeter of mercury. Coming to the next point now, it is factors which contribute to blood pressure. Blood pressure mainly depends on four factors. Number one, cardiac output. Number two, blood volume. Third one is peripheral resistance. And fourth one is blood viscosity. Cardiac output refers to the amount of blood ejected by heart in 1 minute. Or in other words, we can say it is the force with which heart pumps the blood. Blood volume means amount of blood flowing in arteries. If the blood volume increases, the pressure exerted against the arterial walls also increases. And if the blood volume decreases, the blood pressure falls. For example, in case with hemorrhage and bleeding, blood volume decreases and automatically blood pressure falls. Now come to the peripheral vascular resistance. It is the resistance to the blood flow determined by the tone or flexibility or elasticity of vascular muscles and the diameter of lumen. Smaller the lumen, greater the resistance. Ultimately, blood pressure rises. Come to the last factor now. It is blood viscosity. Blood viscosity means the thickness and stickiness of blood. It is a direct measure of the ability of blood to flow through blood vessels. If blood viscosity increases, the blood pressure also increases. Four types of blood pressures are recognized. They are systolic pressures, diastolic pressure, pulse pressure, and mean pressure. Remember, the systolic and diastolic pressure are the actual pressures which exist, and we measure these two pressures as blood pressure readings. The remaining two, the pulse pressure and mean pressure, are derived from the systolic and diastolic pressure. Let us see what are these pressures refers to. Number one is systolic pressure. It is the maximum pressure during systole. Systole means contraction of ventricles of heart. In simple words, when your heart beats, its lower part means the ventricles contract or squeeze and push blood through your arteries to the rest of your body. This force creates pressure on those blood vessels, and that's your systolic pressure. A normal systolic pressure is below 120 millimeter of mercury. Let's see what is diastolic pressure. Diastolic pressure is the minimum pressure during the diastole. Diastole means relaxation of ventricles. In other words, diastolic pressure is the pressure in the arteries when the heart rests between the beats. This is the time when the heart fills with blood, and the pressure felt in arteries is minimum. A normal diastolic pressure is lower than 80 millimeter of mercury. Now quickly we will see what is the pulse pressure and mean pressure. Pulse pressure is the difference between systolic and diastolic pressure, whereas the mean pressure is the arithmetic mean of the systolic and diastolic pressure. The blood pressure readings are expressed in two numbers written as fraction. The upper or top number represents the systolic pressure and the bottom number is diastolic pressure. For example, 120 over 80 mm of mercury blood pressure means the systolic blood pressure is 120 millimeter of mercury and diastolic pressure is 80 millimeter of mercury. The relation between systolic pressure, diastolic pressure and pulse pressure in adults is in the ratio of 3:2:1. For example, if systolic pressure is 120 millimeter of mercury, then diastolic pressure is 80 millimeter of mercury and pulse pressure is 40 millimeter of mercury. Factors influencing blood pressure. There is physiological variation of blood pressure. It means all the persons do not have the same blood pressure. The blood pressure varies person to person. This variation is due to certain factors such as age. Blood pressure varies throughout the age. As age increases, blood pressure also rises. For example, the systolic pressure in childhood varies from 90 to 110 millimeter of mercury. In puberty, it reaches 110 to 120 millimeter of mercury. And in old age, the systolic pressure reaches around 140 to 145 mm of mercury. Sex. After puberty, males have higher blood pressure than females. But after menopause, women tend to have high blood pressure than male of same age. Diurnal variations. Usually persons have low blood pressure in early morning and gradually raises and peaks. It peaks in evening. Body size or obesity. It is observed that as the body size increases, blood pressure also fluctuates. Heavier and taller child have higher blood pressure than the smaller child of same age. Hormones. Hormonal alteration also leads to variation in blood pressure. For example, during pregnancy, hormonal alteration may cause mild to severe elevation in blood pressure. Emotions and stress. Anxiety, fear, pain, and emotional stress may increase blood pressure because of increased heart rate and increased peripheral resistance. Medication. Medicines or drugs may increase or decrease blood pressure depending on their pharmacological action. Diet. Blood pressure increases after eating food. Some food causes high blood pressure, such as diet rich in salts and unsaturated fatty acids. Smoking. Smoking increases blood pressure due to nicotine. Exercise. Regular exercise decreases the blood pressure and helps in keeping blood pressure normal. Just we have learned blood pressure changes naturally due to various factors. Most changes are normal and predictable. However, if the blood pressure readings are persistently changed to really high or low than the normal readings, this alteration of blood pressure is indication of health issues. The alteration may be of two types, hypertension and hypotension. Hypertension is also known as high blood pressure. It refers to a long-term medical condition in which the systolic pressure and diastolic pressure are persistently elevated. Some causes of hypertension are kidney ailments, hardening of arteries, obesity, physical stress, smoking, and heredity. Hypotension, which is also known as low blood pressure. It is fall in blood pressure below normal range. The main causes are pregnancy, heart problems, endocrine problems, dehydration, blood loss, severe infection, allergies, or lack of nutrients in diet.